So I guess that begs the question, where do you begin with actors in your exploration of character? I mean, I'm sure that it's very different with every actor. And I know you had, you know, you have special relationships with different actors, but how does, I mean, let's start with casting, for instance. Where does that, is what is it that, for instance, to take a very specific example, sparked you with Philip Seymour Hoffman with Capote?
I think of all of the disciplines within filmmaking, casting is probably the most misunderstood and underappreciated discipline, you know, art form within itself. Because character, I think, is story. In the case of Phil, I had known him and we were friends. And when I first presented him with the script, he said, you know, he read it and he said, hey, why don't you come over? And we went onto his balcony when he was living on Sheridan Square. And he was really turned on by the, you know, the story, the character. But he said, right now I weigh 240 pounds and I'm like 5'10", something like that. And it just seems possibly ridiculous and reckless. And I'm trying to think back to what the difference between me now and then is, because I don't think I would make a decision like that. It just seemed so out there, like taking a shot from half court. The hoops that he had to jump through to make that work physically and with his voice were so profound. But for example, the issue of being short, because he was more than half a foot taller than Truman Capote, and we would, you know, say, well, what does that really matter? You know, why is Capote's height important? It's, you know, it's really about the complex, that how the complex might have contributed to who he was. And it's easy for me to cast very, very tall people, you know, and put him around and to, you know, wardrobe him in a way that like might keep his shoulders tight so his head appears bigger, you know, like a smaller person. But understanding the complexes and, you know, the more we talked about it and the more naturally he just had his divining rod into like who he was and what that struggle was all about and how much, to be honest, he identified with him and how much he identified with him at that moment in his career. That where Capote was in his life and where Phil was in his life, meaning both of these guys were recognized and appreciated as, you know, major talents, but had yet to land the big one. And you know, the more you get into that conversation, the more the physical obstacles just become insignificant, you know, and you say, well, that's my problem. Like, we'll figure out a way to deal with that aspect of it. But once we're plugged into, you know, the inner stuff, you know, you feel a kind of confidence